Hello everyone, welcome back to another EViews video tutorial. In this case, I'm going to teach you how to forecast an ARIMA model, and I'm going to show you how to include the confidence bands, as you can see in this image. And also, I'm going to show you how to edit the graph, so you can add some shading area, and you can make these lines like dashes. And I think it's going to be very interesting for you to be able to include the confidence bands into your forecast, and also to be able to edit the graph in this format. So let's begin with this tutorial. I am in EViews. I'm going to be using the model that we have used in my ARIMA tutorial. I strongly recommend you that if you haven't watched that video, that you go ahead and take a look into that video first, because all we're going to be doing in this video is forecasting, doing the confidence band, and then adding a format to that graphic. So recall we had this ARIMA 113 model that we had estimated for the consumer price index of the USA. Our data went to the year 2020, the month 11. So what I'm going to do then to forecast, I would like to forecast 12 more observations until the year 2021, month 12. So I'm going to go into range. The first thing you need to do is to expand your data set. So I'm going to just add one more year. So I'm going to go to 2021. And EViews is telling us it's inserting 12 observations. I want to continue, that's fine. Now we have that our sample is going to go to 2021. I can go into my series. I can go into the spreadsheet. And you will be able to see that we have all missing data for the observations that we have added to the sample. So we would like to forecast those. I'm going to go then into my ARIMA model, which, as I already mentioned, this is something I covered in my previous tutorial. We're going to go into forecast, and what we are going to do is to just select this option here, a consumer price index. That's the name that we would like to give to the series that EViews is going to generate. I'm going to type in here the last observation that I would like it to start from is 2020, month 11. And I would like it to go until 2021, month 11. And something very important if you want to add the confidence band is to include the standard error options. So I'm going to type here, for example, SE, which is for standard errors. You can give any name you would like, and this is going to generate the standard error series. So I'm going to, here it's asking you if you want to insert the actuals for the out-of-sample observations. I'm going to remove this option. I wouldn't like to have all the series. I would just like to have the forecast values. I'm going to show you what I'm talking about now in a second. I'm going to click OK. And here we get the forecast. So as you can see, EViews include some confidence bands in the forecast. And the way that this confidence band are estimated is using plus minus two standard errors. So that's what we are going to try to include in our graphic. The problem with this is I'm going to close already the forecast, that when you go to the series that is forecasted, I'm going to open CPI forecast. As you can see, we have checked that box that is telling us not to include all the values for the in sample. We only care about the out sample. Here are the values that we have forecast. And as I mentioned, we don't have here the confidence band. We don't have any other data that we can include in our graphic. However, what we are going to do is going to manually calculate this. So remember that I included the options for the standard errors. Here they are. These are the standard errors for the forecast. I'm going to go down, scroll down. And these are the standard errors that EViews has forecast. So the way that the confidence band work with EViews is it's adding and resting, yes, and subtracting basically two standard errors to the forecast. So what I'm going to do then is going to go into the command section in here, and I'm going to type the following series. That command is telling EViews that you want to generate a new series, and I'm going to call it UB, which is for upper bound. And I'm going to type now my series, which is the forecast. So I'm going to type CPIF. And now I'm going to be adding two standard errors. So I'm going to type 2 times, and then the standard error series. And you can see now that EViews has generated my series. Let me maximize this. Has generated the series UV. And I can open, for example, the forecast and UV together, which is the upper bound of the confidence bands. We can scroll down. And we can see that now here we have the upper bound. This is the mean forecast. And this is the upper bound of the forecast. Now let's go with the lower bound. So what I'm going to do then for the lower bound is to type the same thing, series. Now I'm gonna call it LV for lower bound. And I'm going to type CPIF, which is the name of my forecast. And now instead of adding these two standard errors, I'm going to be removing the two standard errors. Two times standard errors. You hit enter. And now you have here the series lower bound. So let's open everything together. I'm going to open the CPI, I'm going to open the forecast, the lower band, and the upper band. We open it as a group. So here we have our real series, consumer price index. This is our forecast, this is the lower band, and this is the upper band. So let's scroll down. And as you can see, the original series, of course it doesn't have all the forecast values. These are observations that we did out of sample. This is our mean forecast, and these are the two confidence bands. Something that I would like to do is so our graph, it looks uniform. For this observation, the 2020 month 11, I would like to have the starting point all the same, so the graph looks uniform. So I'm going to go into edit. I'm going to include, for all of these values, I'm going to type 260.817. So basically all I'm doing is we are starting, this is the last in sample observation we have, and I would like all my graph to start from there. Okay, so that's all I'm going to do. The next step is for you to go into view. You're going to go into graph, and we're gonna leave lines and symbols for now. And here we have, this is the mean forecast, and this is the upper bound, and this is the lower bound. So now what I want to teach you is how to format this graph so then it looks more professional. The first thing that we need to do to add format to this image is to freeze this image. I'm going to go into freeze. I'm going to go into off, that's fine. And the reason why we use this option is because if we don't freeze this image, we are not going to be able to add lines and also to add a shaded area. The second thing you should do is to add a name to this image. So let's put forecast, for example. So that's the way it's going to be called. And now the second thing that I would like to do is to change the format right away from the color of the background. What I can do is I'm going to use a template for this. I'm going to go into templates and objects, and I'm going to use the predefined template that is simple. I'm going to hit OK. As you can see, now it has changed a bit the format, and also the background is white. If for some reason your EViews version doesn't have the option to use this template, what you can do is double click on the image anyways, and you're going to go into frame and size, and you're going to go into the background option, and you'll make sure that you select white and that the color is solid. So okay, now we have the image. What we have done is we changed the background. It looks a bit better. The second thing that I would like to do is to add the line and the shade. So I'm going to give right click and select add lines and shading. So for the line, I would like the line to start in the observation where started the forecast. So I'm going to select 2020 month 11. And then the shade area. For the shade area, I would like to start from 2020 month 11. But then I would like it to go until 2021 month 11, that's fine. So make sure it starts in 2020 month 11 and ends in 2021 month 11. We select OK, and now we get the shade. So that's perfect. Now we have the shaded area. And the next thing that we're going to do is to change the format of the lines. So for that purpose, what I'm going to do is, for example, I'm gonna double click on the lines, that's fine. Now it's going to open the options to give the format. And we're going to change to patterns. You have pattern use, you have auto choice, solid always, or pattern always. So we're going to use the patterns. I actually like this blue color for the actual series, that's in blue, that's fine. But I would like these forecasts, both the upper bound and the lower bound, to be red. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to go into this line that we have the green line, as you can see, is the lower bound. I would like this line to be red. So I'm going to select the red here. I hit OK. And the next thing that I'm going to do is to change the pattern to these dots in here. And now let's go with the upper bound. The upper bound is this darker red. So what I'm going to do is to change the color and go to the red. Hit OK. And I'm going to select as well the dots. So now here we have the two upper bounds and the lower bounds are going to look with dots and in red. And I would like this forecast, the middle forecast, to remain orange. And you can pick whether to keep it solid. We can probably keep it solid. So I'm going to select the solid line. And let's go with OK. So now here we get the forecast. You can see the upper bound and the lower bound are with dots. And then the forecast in the middle is in orange. So what we can do as well is, for example, change the lesions. So for that, I'm going to double click on the lesions. We're going to give a name. Let's put CPI to the series. This one, we're going to call it CPI forecast. The lower bound, we can call, we can put lower bound. And in brackets, we can put the lower bound is calculated as -2 standard errors. And then the upper bound, we can type upper bound. And similarly, we can type +2 standard error. So whoever is looking at this graph knows how the confidence bands were calculated. So we're going to hit in OK. And now here we have the graph. As you can see, we get the line is CPI forecast, lower bound, upper bound. And what we can do is give a title to this. So I'm going to right click. Add text, we're going to go center, we're going to go into above center, and we can put CPI USA, then we give enter to go to the second line, and we're going to put actual and forecast. Hit OK, and here you see we get the title, and then we can put in the axis as well. We put add text. We're going to go into center, the position, we're going to put it into bottom, below center, sorry. And we're going to type time. So now we get here the axis. And let's add the last one, that is add text. And I would like it on the left. We can put left rotated, so it's going to appear in this direction. And we can put index in here. Hit OK. So there we go. We have the legends. We know what we have. We know how we calculated the lower bound and the upper bound. We have the shaded area for the forecast. And as well, we have all the labels properly set. So that's going to be all for today. I hope you found this video useful. And I would like to invite you to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you would like to get more videos that are related to applied time series and forecasting. And I'm teaching both in EViews and Stata. And well, that's going to be all for today. Thank you very much for watching.